ויפתח השם את פי האתון. The Torah tells us a story about Bilam and a donkey, that it's a conversation between animal and a person. Famous story how was a evil man by the name of Bilam tried to curse our nation. Bilam hit him with his stick, hair with stick. It's a she donkey. And then the Torah said that she opened her mouth, they have a conversation. She said, "How, why you do it to me, etc." The same manner, you see the famous story at the beginning of creation, how the scorpion, the snake, have a conversation with Eve. You see other manner of conversation. You see how, for example, angel of God talking to people, from Abraham to Manoach. So there is a mystical aspect in the Torah. There are four different avenues in the Torah. It's called Pardes. One of them is the Sod. It means that it's the esoteric part of the Torah. So there are certain aspects in Judaism that, by the way, there are other religions that follow that footsteps, that they believe in the secret part of the divine, of the divinity that is hidden from people. It's a famous story, again, those legends, you can either take it or not, in the famous city of Vilna. It's a big Lithuanian Jewish community used to be in the Vilnius, and it's part of Russia. And the story goes that it was during Friday, when they used to have those fish, and they prepare those fish for Shabbat. You heard the story, right? And it was a fish that people claim that said Shema Israel while they did it. And they have a burial site for that fish that said Shema Israel. It's written in a few books. It's another story I heard not long ago. It's a Spring Valley in New York, close to Muncie. So there is a very large Hasidic sect. It's called Square, New Square. And they have Hasidic Rebbe. They are very successful. So the story goes that while they're preparing the fish for Pesach, it was one fish that was talking, and they caught him and they brought him to the Rebbe, and no one wants to say what happened, how it happens. But it's a story. So again, it's a mystical aspect that we don't know much. There is a book by the late Rabbi Chaim Vital, who was a student of the Arizal of 16th century, who tried to describe a certain transmigration of souls that came back, etc. So soon we're going to hear a conversation between certain entities that they are not people, and we need to comprehend what's involved here. So we can take it in two different directions. There's a book called Ya'avetz. He said that when you read, for example, the word para, cow saying certain things, it's the same as you read in the Torah that Hashem opened the mouth of the donkey. Another book, it's called She'arim Metsuyanim Bahalacha, also have this attitude. It says the same way as the angel talked to Manoach. Remember the story we study about the parents of Samson, that they dedicated him to be the man of God, etc. He said that your son will be Nazir for the rest of his life. So here the same way that you read about a cow, that all of a sudden the cow was just laid down, and the person, the owner, tried to push her to come up, and she refused. And as much as he tried in different direction, she was there on the floor. And then the interpretation, the understanding is like she says, If I stand up, I'll be a Nazirite. It's like strong refusal. And it means that she's like refused to be slaughtered. It's like refused to use her body for meat. So it's like the person said in exchange, okay, if I will not make you stand up, I will be Nazirite. So the point is, if a person did not say it in a very lucid, clear way, it's not a Nazir. In order for a person to be a Nazir, a Nazirite, he needs to express himself clearly. So we are on Tractate Nazir, page 10, two lines from the top of the page. Amar, Amra, Farazo. If one said, and I repeat the point, you can take it literally, you can take it esoterically, okay? The concept is the key important here. The cow said, Hareini nezira im omedet ani. I commit myself to be Nazirite if I stand up. Or if he said, Omer adelet hazeh, the door said, this door says, Hareini nezira im niftach ani. I'll be Nazirite if I'll be open. So the Sun Digma asks, it's not that the door speaks, it's the appearance, the interpretation of a person who understands certain things by certain action, by certain event that happened in his life. And later you see a disputation between the house of Shammai to house of Hillel in regards to that expression. It's like you see a person who tried to turn on the engine of his car, and he tried, and it's not moving. So he said, this is my last chance. If it's not open, I'm going to walk to my house. Right? So you can take it in many different directions. What does that mean? So here, Beit Shammai Umrim, Nazir, Beit Shammai said, that's it. He commit himself to be Nazir, Beit Hillel Umrim, Eino Nazir. Amar Rabbi Yehuda, Af Kshamru Beit Shammai, that this expression that the person become Nazir, either lo amru or omrim, depend of the girsa. Ela beomer harei farazo alai korban im omedeti. It's to say that this cow is forbidden to me as an offering if it stands up. So therefore, Beit Shammai hold agreed that he's not committing himself to be Nazir. And they hold that these both, the cow and the door, prohibited upon himself with this manner of vow. That's the Rosh explained. Beit Hillel said, not only that he's not a Nazir, but it's also he's not prohibited from these two entities, from the cow, from the door. So the key is if he said something afterward. If he didn't say anything, everyone said that he's not Nazir. Para mika mishtaya. The Gemara asks, does really the cow speaks or the door speaks? What does that mean? Amar Rami Barchama acha b'mayaskinan. You have to say, kigon shaita para revutza lefanav. So you have a cow that was prone before him. And he tried to ever stand up, and she didn't. The Amar, and the person have in his imagination, Rabbi Nozril said in Shita Mekubezet, the person have in his imagination that she, meaning the cow, is thinking, Kisvura para zo eina omedet. He feels that this cow, it's not stand, so it means that he interpreted the cow saying, if I'm standing by myself, people will prohibited from deriving benefit from my meat. It's like the Rosh explained in the second interpretation. It's like a person make a vow at the time of crisis, time of great stress. So here, it's like the cow asking a heavenly help that she will be able to stand by herself, and she's like prohibited her meat with the hope that that will help her to stand up. In a sense, sometimes you see people go to a park and you see people talking to the dog like they're talking to human. Mm-hmm. I'm right? Mm-hmm. Yes? Yes? I noticed that in this country. Yeah. When I walk, I couldn't believe. At the beginning I thought maybe they're talking on a cell phone. And then I realized no. The worst part, then you see that they're cursing and beating up the dogs. That's bad. Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah. But people talking to the animals. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know. Who am I to figure out what's going on? But anyway, since the person doesn't have a real reason to say the word of the cow, so it's like he agreed with the cow's statement, right? Hareni nazir mibsara im amda meleah. Meaning, the Rosh explained, that he is like, said, all right, if she is going to stand independently, I prohibited myself to eat that meat. Come on, stand up, right? She's not standing up. All right, whenever she stand up, I'm not going to eat your meat, right? Just stand up, right? The same with the door. A person see that the door is locked, right? So he already imagining that the door is speaking to him, right? And he gets to that point that, like in the movies, right? That door say, okay, if I'll be open by myself, I'll be a Nazirite. So it's in a person, the Rambam call it the akuach hamedame, the power of the imaginations, the person say. Ve'amdame elea, and all of a sudden, guess what happened? Stand up. She stood up. So Rami Bar Chama explained the disputation between Beit Shammai and Beit Hillel in this regard. Beit Hillel l'shitatam. Beit Shammai d'amru min agrogrot u'min advela. Remember we said yesterday, if someone committed himself to be Nazir, except upon himself Nazirite, from what? From the figs. Remember dry fig, other figs. Have a Nazir, even though we said that usually it's not the usual manner of commitment. You remember original idea in the Torah, what is Nazir? Nazir is someone who said what? He committed himself that he prohibited himself from drinking wine. Remember that? From shaving or cutting hair, and from contamination to a dead body. That's the three entities involved in normal manner of Nazirut. Someone talk about other things, that is a discussion, if that's really Nazirut or not. Hachaname ki amar, here we make a juxtaposition and we said it's the same way. If someone said, I committed myself to be Nazir, meaning not to eat mibsara from the cow's meat, have a Nazir. So he is basically, is now under this fence that prohibited himself from eating the cow's meat. Ubeit Hillel, and according to Beit Hillel that said that he is not Nazir. Why? Because it's not a matter of Nazirut when it's come to grogrot, the dry figs. Omrim lo have a Nazir. So Beit Hillel said he is not considering Nazir. Why? Because you don't have this type of Nazirut when it's come to meat, which means a person do not accept upon himself Nazirut in something that it's not, the Nazirut is not relevant to them. So therefore, he is not Nazir. So here you see that according to Rami Bar Chama, the disputation between the house of Shammai and the house of Hillel and Mishnah is the same as we have in the previous Mishnah. So the Gemara asks, Veha amarua Beit Shammai. But Beit Shammai have said Chada Zimna one time, which is they already said it in the previous Mishnah. So what's the reason of the repetition? Why? Because if someone he didn't express himself clearly, he committed himself for Nazirite, but he's only have quote-unquote the thought of the cow. So you may say that here the big question is not according to Beit Shammai, but according to Beit Hillel. Because as long as the person did not say it clearly, so how do you know, the Rosh asks, that he is really in that limitation of Nezirut? Amar Rava, Tartei Tlait. In two and three places, which is Grogerot, the figs, cow and doors, they hold that way. That's the way Tosfot said. Bechen Tane Rabbi Chia, Tartei Tlat. Vechen Amar Rabbi Yoshaya, Tartei Tlat, Utzriche. So Beit Shammai needs to bring the view in three different locations. The E it marbeha, if you bring their view only there, grogrot, udveila, the dry fig, the pressed figs. I may say hatam ude amrei Beit Shammai have a nazir. Over there the Beit Shammai hold that he is nazir. Mishum de michalfan ba'anavim, because they are both fruits and a person mix up between them, or because those figs cause a person to be drunk. So it means that the person thought about one thing from grapes and it turned to be a dry fig. Aval basar ba'anavim lo michlaf. You cannot tell me that the person mix meat instead of grapes. So therefore you may say that because of that, Beit Shammai agreed to Beit Hillel that he is not Nazir. So therefore you need a Mishnah to teach us that according to Beit Shammai, you have a framework of Nazirot. Even someone said only, I prohibit myself from meat. Ve'i itmar basar. If the word of Beit Shammai applies solely for the meat and not in regards to dry figs or pressed figs, I may say, ha'cha hu de'amre Beit Shammai have a nazir. Over there, only there Beit Shammai said that he is nazir. Bevisra ve'chamra. Because usually wine and meat are attached to each other. You see it in the menu of restaurants, right? You see a meat and you see a wine, especially French restaurant, right? It's based what the text said in the book of Proverbs, chapter 23, verse 2. They said, Al tehi besovei yain, bezolelei basar lamot. Don't be among those people who occupied themselves with wine and meat all the time. That's the Rosh explained. So usually the Rivan said that people use this term, wine and meat and wine. And therefore, that's what said, that people mix the two. Because again, that's part of the regular manner, even though it's different items, but people attach them in their mindset. Aval grogrot udveila. However, dry fig and pressed fig, since they are not attached to each other, meaning they don't touch together with wine, a person will not mix up and not switch between them. So even according to Beit Shammai, if someone commit himself from the dry fig or from pressed fig, lo, you may think that he will not be Nazir. Kamash melan, so therefore the Mishnah come to teach us that he is Nazir according to Beit Shammai, regardless if he said from the meat or if he said from the dry fig or the pressed fig, etc. Ve'i itma hanetarte, if we said in this Mishnah, these two, which is the fig and the meat, and not the one who said, I become a Nazirite from this door, I may said, Hanehu de Ka'amre Beit Shammai. In this year, Beit Shammai hold that he is considering a Nazirite because a person can mix between grape and figs, between wine and meat, aval delet, but door has nothing to do with wine or grapes. Eima modu lehu leveit Hillel. So you may say that Beit Shammai agreed with Beit Hillel that he is not Nazir. So therefore, the Mishnah needs to teach us that in this case, he is a Nazir according to Beit Shammai. Which means you do not have Chalot Nazirut if he commit himself from that door. Ve'itana delet behaka amre Beit Hillel, that he is not considered Nazir because there is no connection to the door, between a Zirut and a door. Aval behach tartei, with the meat and the fig, he may mix up in his language, Eima modulo le Beit Shammai, that he is Nazir, kamash melan de lo, that even someone said that I commit myself from the figs or from the meat, is nothing. Now, there's a book called Maharit. He is a responsa of an issue. As you know, one of the things that the Jewish community suffered throughout generations since the destruction of the second Beit HaMikdash was the sinat chinam, the causeless hatred that people just mean to each other. That's the reason why we still do not have the third temple. So one of the responses that he dealt was a community in Europe, that a rabbi that was serving the community for many, many decades, he wants to retire, and he wanted to have his son take over the community, to be the rabbi of the community. And Rashi HaKahal, the heads of the community, it's like in our, here is like the president, whatever, the board, they didn't want that. And so what happened is the rabbi get together the community, the congregation, and he wants to announce that his son is taking over the kehillah. So the president was rude, and he said to him, what do you mean that you want? It's not you want. I heard the Rebbetzin that she pushing you to have your son taking over. And he said it publicly. So the rabbi took an oath and he said that he has nothing. She have nothing to do with this. So the president said, oh, so that's the case. The rabbi is not truthful because I heard the Rebbetzin and he make an oath in vain. So the rabbi said, you will be nedui, you put him in under the excommunication. It was very unpleasant back and forth. The rabbi's life is not really a pleasure, I promise. Mm. So anyway, so it was a big machloket, big disputation, and the one before the Maharit was the one of the permanent rabbis, permanent posek. So he said to them, look, you agreed for a decade that he was a righteous man, he was a spiritual leader, he was a good man, he did good. Absolutely. So he said, how do you know what he meant when he made this vow? when he make this expression. Maybe he may say he meant to say that she doesn't know that I'm also want my son to be the next one. Maybe he have a different intent. You should melamed zchud. You should say a positive things about him, especially since he served you for so many decades. So, in short, he just, how do you say it in English, throughout the case, just didn't want to listen to them. But anyway, there is a discussion sometimes among the rabbis if that's possible. It's a story in a Jewish community in the I think in Hungary, about Chatam Sofer. It was three rabbis, Chatam Sofer, Ktav Sofer, Shevet Sofer, grandfather, son, and grandson, that took over the community, not always peacefully. But there is some concept of heredity in this, and there are some who claim that they have some access and some rights over decades. Anyway, one thing I promise you, I can say it on air, that my last imagination in life is to take over, God forbid, my father's job. He was a rabbi for a little more than 50 years in the community. It is a nice community, but absolutely not for me. Amar Rava, Mikatane im amda me'eleha. It's written in the Mishnah that the intent of the cow is to commit herself to be Nazir in order for her to stand up. So why the Mishnah not mention this scenario that the cow said, I will stand independently? So Ela Marava Kigon Shaita Farah Revutza Lefana. Guess what happened? You have the cow that was there prone before him. So therefore it's like appear that she have a hard time to stand up. The Amar, and the person said in his imagination that she have such a great desire to stand up, that she is like saying, if I will do it independently, regardless if it's by help or by myself, I will be a sacrificial offering for this Nazir. So when he is talking, is like he is saying about himself, Hare alai korban, I committed myself to bring the sacrificial offering of Nazir. So here you said you have a disputation between the house of Shammai and the house of Hillel. If a person expresses the cow's thought, if that considering as acceptance of Nazirut, according to Beit Shammai, he is a Nazir. Why? Because it's this expression. According to Beit Hillel, it's not considering that he accepting upon himself Nazirut. It's like, as we said earlier, a person sitting on the freeway, try to turn on the engine, try, the car is not turned on, and he says, okay, this is my last chance. If it's not turned on, I'm going to walk. So it means that that's almost like a language of commitment. Bishlama para, but korbanhi. So we understand that it's possibility because you can take the cow and make her an offering. Ela delet bat korbani. But when you speak about the door is an offering, how can this his vow that the door should be an offering be considered an acceptance of Nazirut? Ela amarava, kegon shehaita para revutza lefanav. It was a cow prone before him, and the cow refused to stand. Ten bi'ive amar, and he effectively said, because he is in his imagination that the cow refused to stand up. So it's like the Rosh said, it's like he matched his thought of Nazirite with this situation. It's like he profusely refused to do something, even it's prohibited upon himself as long as he's not going to do it. And it's like expression, strong expression of refusal. So it's considering that he's in opposing, and he said, "V'areni nazir minayanim lo amda, v'amda melea." He says, "I'll be a nazir from wine if she's not going to stand up." And all of a sudden, boom! He doesn't Rosh said, he doesn't make her stand up. She independently stood up. Or somebody else did it. Beit Shammai Savre Tofei Dar Gavra Mushum Mukma Bidei. Beit Shammai hold the essence of this man's declaration relates to raising the cow with his own hands. And therefore, Ve'ah Lo Ukma. So, and he didn't make it, so therefore, Yev Chalot Nezirut, he is accepting the Nezirut upon himself. But there's Savre Mishum Dirvi'ahu, because the reality is that the cow is lying down, Ve'hakamat, and eventually the now stood up, so Beit Shammai ruled that he is not Nazir, and therefore he doesn't have Chalot Nezirut upon himself. Yachem Masef Amar Rabbi Yudav, Kshamru Beit Shammai Lo Amru Ela Bo'omer, Harei Parazo, that's the Bach, Halai Korban, Para Mikamat Pizba Midei. You mean to say that you have a cow that been invested with any matter of legal status? Ela Kegon, you see this, the cow prown. De'ama, the person thought an expression in his imagination. Hareini Nazir Mibsara, he said that I will be Nazirite from her cow, im lo amda, ve amda me'elea. So the disputation is Beit Shammai Savre Tufe de'ahu Gavra Mishum Ukma Biyadehu. The Beit Shammai hold that the man's intention is based upon him having it stand by his own hand, and he did not have to stand, since he did not cause it to stand, his vow of prohibition takes effect. והלא הוקמה עובד ליל סברי תורפי אגב או משום דרביה והקמת. You see that it's so stood, so his vow does not take effect. ובית הילי סברי, אי לא קמת הווי נזיר. ואמרי, בית הילל said in page, in the beginning, and also in the Mishnah page 9, מבשרה, if someone said from its flesh, or anything related to נזירות, for example, the figs, Lo have nazir, he is not nazir just as they rule in a case where one states that he is nazir from dry fig, because nazir have chalot only on the meat that connected to nazirut. Letamei the Sfigmar responded, Letamei the Beit Shammai Kamrei, Letamei the Beit Shammai Kamrei. Beit Hillel are arguing according to Beit Shammai view as follows. Letidan afilu lo kamat nami lo have nazir. According to our view, if this cow stand, a person will not be Nazir, because anyone who commits himself to something that is not connected to the Nazirut, ledidchu, according to your view, Beit Shammai, damritu ave Nazir, that you say that he is Nazir, even he commits himself for something that is not connected to Nazirut, or do le miat, in this circumstance, you have to agree with that, that what? The torfei, the haden gavra mishum derevia, because the intent, or the essence of this man's declaration relates to the fact that the animal was lying down, veha kamat, and it was now stood up. So what you see, Beit Hillel disputed Beit Shammai in two manners. One, if someone said, I commit myself to be a Nazirite from the meat, the Beit Shammai is a Nazir, Beit Hillel said no. Number two, if someone accepted upon himself Nazirut, even from wine, so if it's not stood up, so according to Beit Shammai, he is Nazir, if he is not caused to stand up independently. And Beit Hillel said, as long as she stand up, he is not Nazir. That's the way to spot said. Beit Shammai, lav torfei d'agavra mishum ukma bideyu, ve'halu ukma. And he did not cause it to stand. So you see here that the condition was not fulfilled, so therefore he is not a Nazir. So there is a question that was asked, the Chatam Sofer. It was in the city of Amsterdam, in Netherlands, right, in Holland. So a person, a very wealthy person, passed away, and he left a will, a lot of money, in a special endowment fund. And he stated that that money should be for people who study Torah but go extra mile, go to those small communities, go far away and study Torah, etc. So, as the Mishnah said, Heve golelim kom Torah, right? You should travel the place that you can increase your learning in Torah. So it was a fellow that went there, he studied there, in Germany someplace, and then he lived by that money, and all of a sudden they close up the place. So he came back to Amsterdam. So the question come up, can you give that person the money from that endowment fund, since the condition endowment fund was what? That the person should go to a place to study, that he needs to travel to study there, and now he's local. So some people claim that endowment is only for that purpose. So he is now here local in Amsterdam, why you need to give him the money from that endowment fund? So they said that the Chatam Sofer said, look, the intent was that the person should increase his learning. The fact that they closed up the building, it wasn't his fault. So therefore he said as follows, if the person just want to draw money from that account and is local, he cannot do that, because that was the condition. But since he's already traveled and is coming back by force of circumstance, therefore he can keep getting money from that endowment fund, because Benedarim olchim achar bnei rishon bnei adam. We said many times in language of vow, you go by the intent, the language and the intent that people have. There is a long write-up by the Chatam Sofer.